welcome to Elite Golf Coach's Tip of the Month. This month it's talking about posture. I'm Mark Goom, the head pro at McCunnis, and I'm just going to talk about how to build your posture correctly and how to find the correct weight positioning. What I find when people practice, they don't quite find the spine angle correctly. They tend to bend from lots of different parts of the spine. If you imagine the spine, it can bend into different places, especially from here, your lumbar, your lower spine, and from your thoracic, the top of your spine here. So once we've got two different points where the spine can bend from, and that's really what I tend to find, is that people do the initial bend from the lumbar, and then what happens is then they sort of slouch from the last bit from the thoracic up here and tend to get a little bit rounded. Now what that does, that causes you not to have a nice straight spine angle. It can bring the hips forward, you can then have problems into impact. So if we've got that rounding of spine into impact, it makes it difficult to maintain posture. So into impact, you might get the scrunching feel when you're a bit rounded. Vice versa, if you're over posture, bottom way too out, very taut almost, bottom out, shoulders really back, and they get the lower back doing this reversing position here. This then can create popping out through impact, standing up out of the shot and not being able to maintain posture. So building the spine angle is so key, and I'm just going to show you a simple little tip that will allow you to build the spine angle correctly. So what we're going to do, we're going to put the club out in front of us here, we're going to put the fists forward, I'm going to put the club under my belt, so the club's going to go under my belt, my fists are forward, and my elbows are back. I'm really pulling my elbows behind my body, almost feel like I'm pulling back behind my backside here, okay? What I'm trying to avoid is my elbows being forward. You can see how rounded I get there straight away. I'm trying to feel my elbows back. I'll feel my chest popping out a little bit then when I get this correctly. So I'm just getting comfortably chest out rather than being over postured. So I'm just feeling elbows back, fist forward, club under my belt. And then from here with my knees, feet shoulders width apart, a little bit of knee flex, I'm going to bend over the club, keeping my elbows back. That's the key part. If I keep my elbows back, it will bring my spine down in one piece. And I can then put the club out in front of me, and I built my posture correctly. Okay, so just show you the difference if I had my elbows forward. I can have my elbows forward bent, and you can see here I would get more rounded. So here I'm trying to feel my elbows back, fists forward, and then once you've got the club under your belt, you're bending over the golf club, keeping a little bit of flex in the knees, but keeping the elbows back. It'll bring your spine down in one piece, and there's your perfect spine angle. And it's brought the whole thing down from the lumbar. Okay, so I haven't bent from the top here. I've come down in one piece, and I've learned to bend into the golf ball as opposed to flex into the golf ball or round into the golf ball, which is what I see with the majority of people. If your spine angle's in a better place, you'll be better balanced, but also, very importantly, it'll help you maintain posture into impact, maintain head height into impact, which will give you better contact. If the posture's wrong, you're up against it. So use that drill when you go to the practice area or you go to play and practice. It'll take you a few times to get the feel of it, and once you've done it, you won't have to even think about putting it under there. But maybe at the beginning of your session, just remind yourself of doing that. Club under the belt, fist forward, elbows back, bend over, keeping the elbows back. It'll bring your spine down in one piece, and you'll be absolutely sorted to get that lovely spine angle. Use that, you'll be better balanced, better contacts, and you'll have a more rounded and balanced swing. I hope that helps you. Keep watching, there's more tips coming. If there's any questions anyone asks, put the questions on YouTube or on Twitter at Elite Golf Coach, and I'll try to get back to you and answer any of your questions or anything you want to see tips-wise. I hope that helps you, and I'll see you for next month's tip.